I was thinking about, I mean, I came from a family of like, nobody gives a shit about what you did in the past or like what you're doing now. It's like, prove yourself every day. And also you should approach life without needing the external approval of anybody else in the job that you're doing. Like that should come from within, you know? But I do think it's like an interesting time. And in terms of, especially with people losing their jobs and losing loved ones, it's just, it's like a weird time of grieving for a lot of people. And yeah. I'm with you 100% that like you can grieve, which you talked about, like I needed 24 hours to process everything that's happening, because there is a grieving process of like, I've grown this attachment to this process, this journey, these people that I've invested my time and energy into, and some of those things no longer exist. But did you ever kind of like go through that process yourself, or were you only allowed yourself like that 24 hours and then you're like, okay, life goes on, time to move on?
No, I knock on wood, I haven't been affected on the health department as far as anyone in my family. So it's like, I can't speak on behalf of what that's like, but I can say in my heart of hearts, that's definitely the most devastating part about all of this. And when I make the comments to say like, you should be waking up with that sense of motivation to be doing something, it's not speaking to those people that are dealing with stuff that's so personal to them. That is a completely different thing. And I can't speak on that behalf. And I feel fortunate that my family's healthy. Mm-hmm. But I think what I try to get across and like the message that it is, it's that how long are we allowing ourselves to sit and muster on like negative, negative, negative? Right. And yeah, has the Olympics to pull them out, or not everyone has that and those types of goals. But at the end of the day, if I didn't have the Olympics, I would still be getting my ass up and finding a way to do something, because I feel like I've learned from the past that if like I wake up with nothing to look forward to, it can kind of blend into the Groundhog Day, you know, like yeah. Every day.
And that like leads to depression.
Full of depression. And, you know, I've had my weird issues, not like crazy postpartum, but I've gone through some stuff where it's like, it was dark. And I don't ever want to go back there. And I was always okay with asking for help. And this is definitely a dark time. So it's like, you have the right people in your corner to like, help you to be able to, you know, pull you out and just like knock some sense into you. And that's what a good friend does. A good friend has to be able to be like, pull your head out of your ass, dude. Like, giving yourself this amount of time to be stuck in this darkness, let's find a way to see light. What can we push you towards? What is things that you're aspiring to be? Are you in a job that you love? Is there something else you want to do? And I feel fortunate that, you know, I have a great family, and yeah, it sucks that I lost my job with ESPN for the year, and who knows what the future is going to hold in that department, but it's out of my control.
Yeah.
And I've learned the older I get, if I can't control it, I cannot worry about it, because it will consume me.
Mm-hmm. And have you had to learn that lesson in the past?
Oh my God, all the time. I was a micromanager. I would always want to know. I still will battle that demon with Team Canada when we're together. And it's just like, what's going on with my family? I'm in two different places. I'm not 100% focused, because I never am when I'm away from my kids and my life, because they're my life. And so I always want to know stuff that, and I feel like this time has really like allowed for me to realize that I can only control what I can control. And if I can stay focused on that, and number one, try to be a good mom and like continue to be digging the grind and let, you know, Maddie and the kids see me working hard towards something, it just allows for them to see that like everything's okay. And I think with this time, the number one concern for me is like, this is a weird ass time for my kids.
Yeah.
Like, you cannot go, like, I won't take them into a store. Like, I'll go grocery shopping occasionally and do stuff. Like, my kids have, I have a best quarantine friend. She's one of my best friends. She lives six houses down. We're the only people that see each other.
Yeah.
And three kids. And, like, we see each other and, like, the kids get to hang. And to me, that's, like, normal. But what a weird time for kids to just be, like, having to do school at home on computers and, like, not be interacting and not getting to do everyday life. So for me, it's about trying to make it as normal as we can. We don't crush the news. We don't talk about this thing and how scary it is. And if we do, we catch ourselves and just kind of, like, talk about it in private. Because Maddie's, like, six and she knows she's – or Audrey will just randomly walking around the house and – I can't wait for this coronavirus to be over. And she's stuff. And I'm just like, you're right, dude. I can't wait. It's so funny. But
yeah, I bet, like, through their eyes. Yeah, I'm sure. Cause they're having to process all this weirdness as well.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm trying to make it as normal. This
normal.
Is the time I remember 9/11 being, like, this weird to me when that happened in Canada. Like, my dad came and picked us up from school and he's just like, world's in shit, what's gonna happen? I don't know, you know. And it's kind of that situation right now.